Hey there, everyone. Welcome back to Fake Gamers Club. We're playing more Mario Maker. I'm just gonna do a few more tries with this level. And I know last episode I said we didn't want to do like one level for like the entire episode. And then we continued to do it for the entire episode.
We got close.
This level, in a way, is kind of addicting. Like, it's one of these levels where you know you can't beat it, but you want to try anyways, regardless, because you were close at one time, you know? But that's about it. So, I'll probably do this up until, like, the 3-minute mark, I guess. And if I don't do it, fuck. But if I do, that'll be neat. Alright, 2 more minutes of attempts. Here we go, come on. Maybe it's just the silence that looks out for me. Because I can't be talking.
Yeah. I hate YouTubers are in that problem a lot where they like get really focused into a game and they're like, well, I need to talk, but if I talk, I'm gonna lose my focus.
Yeah. That's.
Oh my god.
YouTubers that don't do commentary videos are really lucky in that regards.
Usually they do post commentary, which we don't really have the time for.
Yeah.
That's where you record after and layer over.
Yeah, I do that occasionally, but I haven't done it in like a while.
But,
Oh, that was kind of risky. Okay.
You're also, like, just losing a lot of stuff if you're doing post-commentary, in my opinion.
Like what?
I think things are a lot more fun when you say it, like, in the moment. I think if you're
more
genuine.
Yeah, it kind of depends on the video. Like, if
unless you're, like, raging in a game.
Yeah.
Then post-commentary is probably better.
Raging is kind of good for content, though.
Depends on your audience.
Yeah, it does.
I'm sure our audience enjoys our rage.
Yeah, they enjoy us suffering, especially me.
I mean, that Mario Kart video got a lot of views, and I was miserable.
Yeah.
I literally kept
saying. I'm pretty sure we all were.
Nah, you were in first place the entire time. You, like, always win. You're miserable in the Mario Party episodes.
Yeah, I guess. But, like, that should be expected. And plus, that game, like, I've been, like, playing Mario Party, like, my entire life.
Same.
And, like, that game is not a skill game. That's, like, a luck game.
Yeah, pretty much. You need, like, to know the bonus stars and stuff to cheese it.
The first few episodes, you kept getting shitty rolls, you didn't get any stars, I'm pretty sure, and then all of a sudden, you got incredible luck after, like, episode 3 or 4.
Well, after you learn, like, what gives the bonus stars, you can cheese that stuff. So, like, I knew there was a candy bonus star, and I started eating candy even when it didn't make sense.
Yeah, it's good to eat those at, like, the ends. Shit, you know what, this series is coming up before Mario Party.
Oh.
So, whoops.
Well, they don't care. They don't know what's going on.
Not like we said we could be talking about Mario Party 9, guys.
Yeah, you know. We should totally record Mario Party 10 after this.
It doesn't work. My disc doesn't work.
Oh.
I would actually need to rebuy it.
Oof.
Yeah.
When are they gonna add GameCube games to the Wii Virtual Console?
I mean, soon.
The eShop. That'd be smart.
I feel like they're going to, like, just finish up with the NES. Okay, that's it.
Alright, that's it. We're done with this level. Sorry,
Kyle. Do easier levels. We're less players, not fucking video game pros, Kyle.
Yeah, we're fake gamers.
Yeah. But yeah, I imagine they just want to finish up, like, with the NES games.
Alright, let's see if we can figure out what the Five Nights at Freddy vibe is here.
Was I supposed to do a thing? I'm, like, actually trapped.
No, you know.
Oh! Hey, guy. Okay, then.
Oof, you died. Chica Bonnie came and scared you.
Okay, so I need the piece. Oh, okay.
Those
I think I need. I think I need to, like, throw it so he lands on it. Oh, but I can't. I can't throw it out.
Oh no, Bonnie's cousin. You're gonna die. put a barrier between you.
Maybe that's like what I need to do.
You think a barrier will work.
Okay, and then that guy.
And then that's probably Chica. Oh, he's gonna come back again. Just kidding.
Oh, I see, okay. What? Why'd he go through it? I clearly put it in front of him. Okay. Okay, so there's four of them. Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
But yeah, there's four animatronics in front of him.
Yeah.
So just put that right there right now.
Yeah, yeah.
Considering that that's he'll show
maybe
up first.
I can't be next to it, but I'm pretty sure I did do this, like, last time. Okay. There it is.
And he'll come out, and now he'll unleash the next one, but he'll come out first. There's yeah. Unlike FNAF, there's an actual real pattern to this.
Yeah, there kind of has to be for this
so
game.
Switch to the other side.
Yeah. Okay.
And now we got the Chain Chomp. Chain Chomp's faster, so I'm pretty sure he's supposed to represent Foxy.
Yeah.
Go back to the other side.
Okay.
Alright, Chain Chomp's coming again.
Stupid Chain Chomp. I imagine Mirko's gonna go that way.
Yeah, now Wiggler comes back.
What? Okay, this level's actually like
kinda
broken.
Kinda glitchy.
Yeah. I'll like it for now, even though it's a famous YouTuber.
Can I try?
Yeah, you can try. Like, I don't know what I'm doing wrong, but... ...from the P-Switch, or something.
Have you ever played a besides when they were super popular when we were in high school? You ever play FNAF?
I only play it from Jake's phone in 9th grade.
Ouch. Oh yeah, I remember that.
Yeah. And that was when I was loud. Like, I was loud off camera back then.
Don't fuck me.
Oh. That was close. Yeah, Goomba.
Roomba.
Wiggler. Yeah, Roomba. You can keep it left for now. Chain Chomp's definitely gonna come right now. Oh! What?
Oh, he bumped into Goomba. Okay.
Bro, that was tricky.
What would I have done in that situation?
I don't know.
Cause like.
That was so sudden too.
Cause like Wiggler was right there too. He was right.
Yeah.
Next to me.
Yeah,
like, so I was supposed to
that's the thing as well. That was not supposed to happen. Like, they should not have touched. I don't know if I made that part of my attempt. Maybe I did.
Oh, wait.
Maybe I didn't, but...
This is a really cool way of implementing, and this is a night theme for the Ghost House, which is nice. So glad they added themes.
Yeah, they did have themes,
Well, like, night theme.
Oh, night theme? Yeah. Actually, did they have night themes in the first game? I don't think
no,
so.
No, I didn't.
Not that I remember, but they definitely did, I think. Okay, left.
Nah, Goomba comes back.
What? Okay. Yeah, this level is like...
A little glitchy.
Definitely wrong.
Nothing's fresh, just wait here.
I don't think anything. Oh. Okay. So,
this was a really good way. This was actually a pretty faithful recreation.
Yeah.
I feel helpless. Right, now I got the Chain Chomp, but the Goomba comes back again. The Wiggler's turn. Chain Chomp comes next. Goomba again. Wiggler again. Goomba comes back. Oh, okay.
Oh, you can go.
I swear to God, that better have just been one night.
There's multiple nights.
Okay.
Oh, you know what? Don't say it here. You hang on, let me see it. And then there's gonna be another night, I assume. Yep. Yeah.
Oh boy.
Wait. No. Just press plus.
That was home.
Yeah.
Alright, who's coming today?
Hey.
We in the FNAF. Oh, is this supposed to be the FNAF 2 location?
I have no idea.
Yeah, that makes sense now.
Oh!
Okay, what?
What? What? That's like actually undodgeable. Maybe go to the right after that happens.
Can he hit me?
Yes, yes he can.
Okay, I don't know. Well, this is supposed to be the FNAF 2 location, I can tell. Done some stuff in.
Yeah, that's definitely a tell that you can go, like, over. Right. Oh! No.
Just SOL.
What the heck? How do you even...
That's just evil.
Yeah, I don't know what he would do.
Quite literally.
Yeah, oh, actually.
Wait, I got an idea.
Yeah. Well, this is not gonna be.
Kill me.
Yeah, try standing in the peace switch.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah, that's like the only thing, and if that doesn't work, I don't know what will.
Oh wait, the P-switch is right outside.
Yeah.
I can't just land on it.
Well, no, try.
Nah, because the P-switch starts right there, so I can't fall into the room and...
Yeah, try standing in it there.
Is it like a Death Star?
I have no idea. Okay.
Yeah.
Hang on, let me try something.
You try something.
I'm sure.
Low key, this looks like it's supposed to be like. Like, I think I. Like, there's nothing you can do, really. It's such a dumb way to change the, game mechanic.
Yeah. Like, there's literally nothing.
I mean, I get it, because in FNAF 1, you shut the doors to get rid of the animatronics. In FNAF 2, you have to put on the mask.
Yeah.
But there's no shelmet. There's no dry bone shell. I can see a chain chomp running.
Yeah. But,
what can I do?
I see a thing over there.
It's one of those levels where you pause, look at it, and you're like, there's nothing you can do.
Yeah, and plus, we can't see anything from here.
Does it get brighter when you hold it?
Yes. I did not mean to actually stand in that. Okay.
You still couldn't have avoided him?
What? Okay, maybe... Okay. No. Like, there has to be a way. If I crouch right here, this level's impossible. Like, there's no way. Okay.
Let me see it for a minute.
Wait. Because that would not be able to work. Actually, okay.
You're like, I'm not so sure about this, actually.
Okay, I'm gonna try two things. One. Oh, we can't throw it out of here, that's right. But, well, this episode's over. There's literally nothing we can do there. Like, I don't know what we can do.
Keep enemies out of your office by blocking openings with the P-switch. Yes. We did that.
And
a 1.5% clear rate.
I'm not sure it's somehow able to, like, bring, like, have the mushroom, like, bring it with us. So Mark would be big there, but then
you would have got hit by the second boo. The iframes would be gone, the boost would stay there.
And plus, you probably wouldn't be able to, like, pick up the P-switch to begin with. Well, I have no idea. It's actually dumb. I don't see how anyone could beat it.
Super expert.
Yeah.
Which is great, because it's a cool level, and I like the design, and it's really faithful.
Yeah,
but
it is.
Like, there was literally nothing we could do.
Yeah, I don't see how it could be done. But, that's probably going to do it for this episode. If you guys enjoyed, if you like Five Nights at Freddy's,
should we play it?
Yeah. If you've liked Five Nights at Freddy's and did and regret it because of those cringy days, make sure you like and sub. Bye.